What's going on, friends? Logan Myers here for Cinefellas.com, and tonight I'm going to be reviewing the Pixar film Coco that is now streaming on Netflix. Sadly, I didn't get around to seeing this in theaters. I've heard nothing but great things about it, but I finally got around to watching it on Netflix over the weekend, and what a great, great film. So let's talk about it, shall we? So Coco, we have a young boy named Miguel, played by Anthony Gonzalez. He voices the character. He's a young boy. He has higher hopes and dreams in his life to be a musician. His family, they build shoes. It's been passed down from generation to generation. He looks up to this musician, Ernesto de la Cruz, very famous back in the day. He was in movies, he made all this music and whatnot. So early on in the film, Miguel's family is very anti-music. It's a curse on the family. You know, trying to figure out why his family is very anti-music and how they want him to basically follow in their footsteps of, you know, taking over the family business and building shoes as a young kid. So Miguel's family finds out about what he's been doing. He has this guitar, he's learning how to play and watching these Ernesto de la Cruz videos, and they're not too happy. They smash his guitar and, you know, he is upset and crying. He has to get away from them. He doesn't want anything to do with his family. So he takes off and he ends up finding Ernesto de la Cruz's guitar. And once he strums the guitar, it takes him into the land of the dead. And this is where things in the movie get a little eerie. Kind of goes in a darker place. And it reminded me of like Tim Burton's Beetlejuice vibe. It was really dark, you know, with all these dead people and skeletons and things like that. But he's in the land of the dead. And he's trying to track down his deceased family to figure out what happened, why there's a curse on the family, why they hate music so much. So when Miguel is in the land of the dead, the color schemes are absolutely beautiful. It really plays on, you know, the Mexican culture, you know, vibrant colors and things like that. The way that it's so realistic, you can't tell that it's animation, it looks so real. You know, as I said in my Incredibles 2 review, Pixar is top of the game when it comes to animation. Other studios really can't compare to Pixar because they're the best at what they do. And this is a perfect example of how the animation is so top-notch. And so Miguel comes across a character named Hector. He's kind of a scoundrel, scumbag. Really not sure if you can trust him or not, but he basically befriends him, and Hector's trying to help him out finding, you know, his family and Ernesto de la Cruz, and it really sets up their relationship. But again, it's also with Hector, you don't really know if you can trust him or not, but later on in the movie you see how many layers are to this individual and why he is there and why he's trying to get back, and something that has to do with this photo. The rest of the movie, you know, of Miguel finding his relatives and trying to find Ernesto de la Cruz and finding out really what his family is and who they are and who his great-great-grandfather, whatever it was, great-great-grandfather. I'm not sure. There's a lot of greats in there. But, you know, figuring out who that is and him trying to meet his idol and, you know, and young Miguel trying to follow his dreams and to become a musician. He has to go in the land of the dead to encounter these people and understand where his family came from. And finally encountering Ernesto de la Cruz is really interesting because he was such a huge idol for young Miguel, but finally coming across him in the land of the dead, you know, you're not really impressed. You see that he's actually is a scumbag. End of the film, Miguel, you know, has come across so much in this story of, you know, crossing over to the land of the dead and finding why everything has happened with his family and his great-great-grandfather. So overall, leading up to the end of the film, there's a lot of great themes and stories here that to be learned from an audience standpoint, you know, realizing that family is everything. They really have the best intentions for you or for Miguel as a young child, you know, pointing him in the right direction. And they do that for good reason in terms of music and finding out why everything happened and why there's a curse on the family in terms of music. So a lot of great stories here. Pixar always has really heartfelt, pull at your heartstring stories and films that really, really touch a lot of people in different ways and a lot of different levels. And I absolutely loved Coco. I went in with really not knowing too much about the movie, but had a great time with it. Really was involved in the story and these characters and just going into this world of the land of the dead with the great animation and the music and the vibrant colors and really depicting, you know, the Mexican culture and the Day of the Dead. The last 10 minutes of the film, if you do not tear up a little bit, you are not human, because it made me tear up a lot, and that's what Pixar is really good at, is really pulling at your heartstrings. So if you guys have not seen this movie, definitely check it out. It's streaming now on Netflix. Overall, I'm going to give Coco a 4.5 out of 5 hat pieces. So what'd you guys think of Coco? Did you guys see it in the theater? What'd you like about it? What didn't you like about it? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to hit subscribe. This is Logan Myers signing out from the Land of the Dead. Until next time, cheese!